Morning, Father.
Oh, morning, Patrick. Oh, it is a lovely day, isn't it? Oh, I'm afraid you'll have to excuse me. I've just got a telephone call. I'll see you at Mass next week. Father Gabriel. Oh, Father Peters. God, that was a grand Mass last night, wasn't it? What? Hang on. Hold, slow down. Slow down. You're not making any sense. You want confession.
Name of the Father and of the Son, Holy Spirit. My last confession was 5 weeks ago.
He who covers his sins shall not prosper, but he who confesses and forsakes them shall have mercy.
Forgive me, Father, for I have sinned.
What's on your mind?
Father, I have sinned greatly.
Come on now, we're all sinners. Even us priests are only human. Tell me more.
I've come to the point where I need to break the rule of confession.
What? Why?
Father, I cannot keep silent anymore. I am ashamed of my behaviour. I have to make peace with the Lord. My conscience has to be cleared.
I am worried about you. Tell me what happened.
It all started when a man came into my booth. He hadn't been to confession since he was a child. He explained that he'd been doing this atrocious thing for quite some time. I wasn't told about all the bad things, but what I did hear, well, that was bad enough.
Forgive me, Father, for I have sinned. It's been 17 years since my last confession.
17 years? Why so long?
It's been a long time, and I have accumulated many sins.
So, what are these sins?
Many sins of the flesh and of the mind.
What do you mean?
Father Peters, if you saw a broken and disembodied soul, what would you do?
I'd help them, of course.
And how would you describe a good Christian?
Someone who accepts Jesus Christ as their saviour and follows in his footsteps.
You see, Father, I knew a girl. She liked to party every day and every night. Sniffing cocaine, smoking, drinking, going wild.
This girl a friend?
Well, somewhat of that nature. We met up at a local bar. I was alone, in my own world, drinking scotch. The devil's poison, as they say.
This man, he met this woman on some social networking site.
Really? What, like those hook-up chat sites?
Yeah, I think so.
Oh, I think I've heard of one of them. You got Skype. Well, then, of course, you got MSN Messenger, Facebook, Twitter, Bebo,
MySpace. Father, please. Let's just stick to the point.
I do apologise. Please continue.
He told me of this girl named Lexi, who he had met at a bar. They danced and drank. He described the woman as a great sinner.
A great sinner?
Yes, Father. A great sinner.
A soul full of sin. Corrupted by the destruction of society we have been brought up in. The world is an ugly place, and she reflects it perfectly. After a few drinks, she invited me over to her place so we could get more acquainted.
More acquainted? What do you mean?
Well, let's just say I fulfilled her every need.
Marriage should be honored by all, and the marriage bed kept pure. You see, my child, the devil is strong, but God is stronger.
Yes, but the flesh is so tempting. But that wasn't all, Father.
Unbelievable. There's more.
I felt that there was some sort of enjoyment in the action that he took. I'm not one to judge, but it's hard not to when a person does it on so many occasions.
What do you mean, so many? Oh no. I understand.
Do you, Father? Really? He told me of another woman. Her name was Susan. From what I remember, they met up at a bar. No, it wasn't a bar, they met up in a restaurant. You'd think being in a public place that nothing terrible like that would happen.
This girl from work. Wow. Every guy in the office had been after her. We got to talking on Facebook one night, and after a while she asked me out for a meal. What was I supposed to say? No? I took her offer, of course. We are both young and single. Why shouldn't I? I'm only human, and the human mind can be weak. So I follow my instincts, which have proven me well in the past. Am I right?
More wine for the lovely young lady?
They made it seem innocent, but it was humiliating. I could see it in their eyes. All they wanted to do was fornicate. I can see it! As if I hadn't noticed. Well, I thought I would teach her a lesson or two.
No, you didn't.
I did what was necessary. We finished our meals after what seemed like forever. All I wanted to do was teach that bitch a lesson. A lesson that you can't just come onto every guy that you meet. It's disgusting, it's disgraceful behavior towards the Lord our God. I paid the bill like the gentleman I am and offered to drive her home. Or at least that's what I wanted her to think. On the way to the car, I noticed the waiter smoking.
This young man sounds like he has a couple of problems with social behaviour. A disorder, perhaps.
She was flirtatious with the waiter. He thought that she would give it to anyone, so he made sure that she wouldn't give it to anyone again. Ludicrous, right?
Yes. Very ludicrous indeed.
Sadly so.
So, what happened next?
He stabbed him to death and put his body in a skip. He said it was easy and it felt good. He mentioned that when he got in his car, he was covered in blood. He didn't care about what Susan thought.
When the screaming started, I made sure the doors were locked. Drove to a secluded spot near the docks, smashed her head in and threw her in the river.
Forgive him, Lord, for his sins. Put light into this dark situation.
Father, honestly, do you teach someone that refuses the light?
We're told as a church that we will go all over the world and invade every sinful culture.
Father, you know what? You're certainly right. In the Bible, we're told to cut off fellow believers who persist in all immoral deeds.
But the Bible also says, whoever withstands the power is against the legislation of God, and they that resist shall receive punishment.
You see, Father, I believe I was brought here by God to do all good and destroy all evil in people's hearts. I am his messenger in this corrupt world full of lust and sin.
But isn't taking a life evil?
But if you have permission.
You can't carry on like this.
Who's going to stop me?
Father Peters, you must understand that the world is full of sin, and all we can do is pray for their forgiveness.
What shall I do? Should I get the police involved? We are not allowed to disclose confidential information about confessions.
You are right. But you need to do what you feel is right from within.
I don't know. I don't know what is right anymore, Father.
Because I love thee, my God, who art all good and deserving of all my love, I firmly resolve with the help of thy grace to confess my sins, to do my penance, and to amend my life. Amen. Father Peters, you have done nothing wrong.
You don't understand. I've allowed the devil to consume my soul. I have betrayed my faith and turned against our Lord's teachings. I had to put a stop to his actions. I could not allow his behavior to continue. He had to be stopped. Father, please say something. Father.
I think we both need a bishop's finger. Come on.